Well, Allie, you'll be happy to know that the furries have returned to Pittsburgh.
Nearly 3,000 of them are in Pittsburgh this weekend for their 11th annual convention. These people have a convention.
They're not people.
This is the largest of its kind in the country.
With a
people
pyramid,
embrace the idea that animals can assume human characteristics. Apparently the reverse is true with a nice itchy costume. That'll get you itching all over again.
Oh yeah. Let's just say, good thing they were in the air conditioning, huh?
I know, that's hot. And it has been baking, you know.
We don't have that convention in Houston.
Yeah, not in Houston. Oh my goodness, not on the West Coast right now. I mean, they have distancing all kinds of record heat.
This is a Gorka Phoenix production.
Can you help me out here? Do you recognize this guy? Look again. my stuff.
No.
Stop by the Forbidden Treasures booth in the next half hour. You'll get an extra 20% off all collars and leashes. Come on by.
I guess we're lucky that blue's not a more popular color.
Hello? This is racial profiling?
We're going to need samples of your fur.
We're also going to need to talk to you without the masks on.
You have a problem with that?
You wouldn't ask a human lady to take her makeup off. If you want to talk to me, this is the me you're going to talk to.
Do you have a name, Miss...
My friends call me Sexy.
Well, lucky you. Now, do you want some help with your helmet?
I'm a lawyer. I know my rights. You can't sequester a domestic animal without due cause.
Well, it's coming off one way or the other, so...
Fine. Fine.
Hello, Sexy.
Okay, happy now?
Thrilled. Let's start at the top. What's your human name, sir?
Bud. Bud Simmons. But I'm no criminal, and I don't have to talk to you people.
You have a very musky odor, Bud. Quite stimulating, I imagine. Look, we found blue fibers similar to the ones on your costume in the stomach of a dead man. Bob Pitt?
Huh?
You may know him as Rocky Raccoon.
You think my costume killed Rocky?
We think it may have incapacitated him.
Rocky was scritching me.
That's one I haven't heard.
Scritching is like grooming. It's friendly scratching. People who don't know each other can't just nuzzle and trade tummy rubs. But for animals, scritching is perfectly normal.
Well, killing is perfectly normal for them, too. It doesn't make it legal for you.
Well, clearly this kitty costume is where Bud felt safe enough to scritch. I wonder if he also felt safe enough to explore some of the more aggressive aspects of his animus.
So, if we follow the ipecac and civet oil, maybe it'll lead us to the shooter. I don't see a compartment for a concealed rifle.
Hi, this is Point T. Weasel from point.furryhost.com and movio.com, and you're listening to The Richard Show on Rant Radio. Pointing out that while you're listening to this, I'm downloading porn. Guess who's got the bigger smile?
For porn.
What? There's always some new site.
For porn.
I browse all day and night.
For porn.
It's like I'm surfing at the speed of light.
For porn.
Trekkie.
The internet is for porn.
Trekkie.
The internet is for porn.
What are you doing?
Why, you think the net was born? Porn, porn, porn.
Trekkie.
Oh, hello, Kid Monster.
You are ruining my song.
Sorry, me no mean to.
Well, if you wouldn't mind, please, being quiet for a minute so I can finish.
Okie dokie.
Good. I'm glad we have this new technology.
For porn.
Which gives us untold opportunity.
For porn. Oh, sorry.
From your own desktop.
For.
You can research, browse, and shop. Until you've had enough and you're ready to stop.
For porn.
Trekkie.
The internet is for porn. The internet is for porn.
Trekkie.
Me up all night hugging me porn to porn, porn, porn.
That's gross. You're a pervert.
Sticks and stones, Kate Monster.
No, really. You're a pervert. Normal people don't sit at home and look at porn on the internet.
You have no idea. Ready, normal people?
Ready.
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 Let me hear it.
The internet is for porn.
Sorry, Kate.
The internet is for porn.
I masturbate.
All these guys unzip their flies for porn. Porn.
The internet is not for porn.
Porn.
Hold on a second.
Wow.
Now, I happen to know for a fact that you, Rod, check your portfolio and trade stocks online.
That's correct.
And Brian, you buy things on Amazon.com.
Sure.
And Gary, you keep selling your possessions on eBay.
Yes, I do.
And Princeton, you sent me that sweet online birthday card.
True.
Oh, but Kate, what you think he do after?
Yeah.
Ew!
The internet is for porn.
Gross!
The internet is for porn.
I hate porn.
Grab your dick and double click for porn, porn, porn.
I hate men.
Porn.
I'm leaving.
Porn.
I hate the internet.
The internet is for internet is for internet is for porn.
We'll be right back.
Okay, well, I've heard of some guys getting off in some weird ways, but humping an animal suit? I mean, whatever happened to normal sex?
What is normal sex?
You think it's natural for a grown human to only be intimate with a talking animal?
Well, Freud said that the only unnatural sexual behavior was to have none at all. And after that, it's just a question of opportunity and preference. And evidently, many prefer the feel of fur to the texture of human skin.
Well, I like hairy chests, but I'm not about to bop a 6-foot weasel.
Bud is starting to look like a pretty bad cat. Trace from his costume?
Well, identical to the trace we found in Rocky Raccoon's vomit, ipecac and civet oil.
Well, that's what you get for eating.
Okay, bud, I'm gonna get right to it. Bob Pitt's semen was found all over your kitty costume.
You lied to us. You were doing a little more than grooming.
It started as a scritch. Then everyone got in a fur pile, and pretty soon we were all yiffing.
I get fur pile. Define yiffing.
In a fur pile, when all the animals start rubbing and wiggling, some of them start to do things.
The kind of things that leave semen on your fur.
That never happened before. Okay, that happened before. I know what you're thinking.
You couldn't possibly.
I didn't kill Rocky Raccoon.
Did you smear Ipecac and civet oil on the back of your costume?
That's crazy. I was there for the yiffing, and that's all. Look, if I don't have my costume on, I pretty much can't get yiffed.
Okay, bud. We're gonna leave you some time to think about it. Enjoy your new costume. You buying this guy?
Oh, who the hell knows what goes on in a fur pile? But if someone doused their special scent on Kitty's back, I'm sure he's going to want to know who did it.
Well, he gives us all the fur names of people in the pile. What are we going to do? Put out an APB on Tom and Jerry?
Maybe we just ask him where the hip, young, plushie on the go likes to hang out.
Password.
E-I-E-I-O.
This is a private party.
We have an invitation from the Las Vegas Police Department.
Oh, okay.
It's a homicide investigation.
Look, we need you to stop scritching or yiffing or whatever. Take off your costumes and tell us your names.
Okay, this is a rant. It is about furries and the people who hate them. And don't tell me when you were a child you didn't play or pretend that you were like a dog or a cat or whatever. What is a furry, you might ask? A furry is a person who likes anthropomorphic animals. Examples are Daffy Duck or Bugs Bunny. Anthropomorphic means an animal that is given human characteristics. Okay, since I covered that, let's get to the point. I am a furry and I'm proud to be one. But sometimes I hear about these assholes making a big deal about furries and the fandom. They say that they're freaks, weirdos, and have no life. And all we like to do is dress up in big animal costumes and fuck one another. What the fuck? Where the hell did these costumes come from? Oh, that's right. They came from that show called CSI. A show where all they like to do is put everything in a bad spotlight. CSI, fuck you. Furries do nothing like that. But furry fandom is just like any other type of fan base. Star Wars, anime, comics, etc. Think about it. All of these fan bases have conventions, books, art, whatever. Furries have the same thing. It may not be the same kind of stuff, but it's the same. When you go to a comic or anime con, what do you see? You see people cosplaying as their favorite comic or anime character. Also, they're probably buying art, talking about their favorite comic book or their favorite anime show, and just having a great time. Furry conventions are the same exact thing. We dress up as our anthro character, buy art or books, and play random idiotic games. It's a gathering of people who share the same interest and having a fun time. What's the difference between the two? Nothing. They're the same damn thing. Another thing to all the fur haters. You say we have no lives, but what about you? While we're out having fun at conventions or hanging with our friends, you're in our room typing on your stupid live journal or on YouTube talking about how much you hate furries. If you hate something, keep it to yourself. Yes, I know I'm sounding like a hypocrite, but I'm just making a point. If we wanted to dress up like a 6-foot tall talking animal and make fools of ourselves, then let us. At least we're having fun doing it. Isn't that what life is all about? Enjoying things and having fun. So all of you fur haters, shut the fuck up and get a life. It's not our fault that your parents probably never loved you and wanted to dump your ass in a dumpster somewhere. We're happy being furries and no one can tell us different. Stop criticizing us and trying to change us for who we'd like to be. That's what it is about you people. You like to shoot us down and prove us wrong. Sailing by in your boat right when we're in the sea wrong. Just by something that we enjoy and or like. So please consider a message before one of you testifying cutbacks try to change our minds or the public viewers. Thank you for watching my video.
We'll be right back. Sometimes.